You know I really love Dragon Ball content when I do a failed stream, a successful stream, and want to do more content when a new Dragon Ball game comes out for the Nintendo Switch. Well, actually, the game isn't even out yet. Yesterday, the open beta for Dragon Ball FighterZ on the Nintendo Switch went live, and I wanted to do a bunch of content on it. During a 2-hour stream yesterday, I thought, you know what, I really enjoy this. Why don't I make a little mini review sort of thing to put on the channel? So here we are. This isn't going to be a full review. As such, it's not going to have a score on it or anything. But here is my mini review of the Dragon Ball FighterZ open beta for the Nintendo Switch. Before we get to gameplay, we're going to talk about connections because this is an open multiplayer beta, which means internet connection is everything. You absolutely need an internet connection to play this beta, even if you want to just do the tutorial. Everything requires an internet connection. And on that topic, while the connection is very good and very stable once you get into the lobby and get into matches, getting to that point was no easy task for a lot of people. This error message reared its ugly head to me and a lot of others the night the beta went live and even the next day. The strange thing is that it had a very easy fix. Restart the app? Nope. Restart the console? Nope. Re-download the app? Nope. The actual solution was to go into your Switch's internet settings, delete your Wi-Fi hotspot from your settings, then go back into the beta and set it up all over again when the beta tried to go online, and everything magically worked fine. Do note that this is also an error message that was a big problem for the PS4 and Xbox One beta. So it's a big question of, if they've already gone through this once before, why is it happening again? And while not directly related to the connections, the game also has a habit of crashing when you're wandering around the lobby. This happened to me once every couple hours. So it's not like it's happening every 5 minutes, but it's one of those things they need to look into fixing. Now we need to take a look at gameplay and what content is offered in this beta. When you're wandering around the hub world, you do have access to 23 different character avatars, so you can do a little bit of customization there. As far as game modes are concerned, you've got the tutorial area, where you can go through 12 different lessons about combat. You've got arena battles, where you can create and join lobbies to spectate or participate in PvP matches. And you've got the replay theater, where you can look at all of your saved replays. Now, the big question that I and a lot of other people had was the character roster. How many characters are going to be available in this beta? And the answer is all of them. Outside of Android 21, all 23 characters from the base game are available to play here. So whether you want to play as villains like Cell or Frieza, or try out the Super Saiyan Blue variants of Goku and Vegeta, you can play as whoever you want. And now we get to the real star of this game, the combat. Dragon Ball FighterZ is a 2D fighting game, which in a lot of cases is the much harder variant of fighting games. But I view Dragon Ball FighterZ very similar to Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom 3. There are a lot of technical combos and strategies that you can pull off, but there are also a lot of simplified ways of doing this as well. You've got abilities like the Super Dash that helps you set up easy to perform air combos. So it's a technical fighter, but it's also a simple fighter, being versatile enough to appeal to both hardcore and casual fans. And on top of that is the visual spectacle in the game. Not just the graphics, but all of the cinematic super moves you can do, all of the recreated anime cutscenes. It makes watching it almost like watching an anime. When I was going through spectator mode in the beta, I was having just as much fun just watching the visual spectacle as I did actually playing it. And that brings us to presentation. FighterZ is one of those games that a lot of people couldn't differentiate from watching an actual anime. The art design and how the animation works just looks like an anime and not a video game. It's even gotten to the point where some of the Dragon Ball YouTubers have been comparing FighterZ to the top-notch animation in the latest trailer for the Dragon Ball Super movie that's hitting North American theaters in January. And on the Switch, it also looks beautiful. It's not quite as picture perfect as it is on the PS4 or Xbox One, as there are a few small jagged edges on some of the character models, but you have to really look closely to be able to find that. Overall, the game looks incredible on the Switch. and looks just as good in handheld as it does in docked mode. And let's talk about performance for a minute. When you're running through the tutorial, you get a perfect 60 frames per second. When you go online, you get good frame rate, but you don't get a perfect frame rate. Whenever I did my online matches, I did see some frame drops. They weren't severe enough that it affected what I was doing, but it definitely wasn't a perfectly smooth 60 frames per second. This could be due to connections of who I was playing with, but it seemed pretty consistent through all the matches that I did. Though funny enough, and very good for handheld fans, I encountered a lot fewer frame drops when I played the game in handheld mode than I did in docked mode. And to quickly go into battery life, I don't have full battery readings because you cannot play this beta offline. But the initial readings were the following. With maximum brightness of the Wi-Fi on, 2 hours and 31 minutes. Lower brightness of the Wi-Fi on, 2 hours and 52 minutes. So we're looking at about 2.5 to 3 hours, but we'll have to wait until the full game releases to get those offline readings. So here are my final thoughts. The game is clearly optimized well, looks beautiful, and plays pretty well for the most part, but has a few things that they need to improve on the connection side. But even if the game launches as it is right now, I still see it as an easy 8 or 8.5 out of 10. Dragon Ball FighterZ is a great game for Dragon Ball fans, and they've clearly put a lot of work into this port. Of course, I'll have a full review when the full game comes out next month. Until then, if you have any questions about the beta, feel free to leave them below, head to the website at reviews2go.home.blog, or download and play the beta yourself, because it's still going until the end of tonight.